Hello, 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 everybody. I hope you're all doing well, and welcome to Behind the Screen, some DM prep for The Lost City of Adranus. This is kind of weird. Let me get some music queued up for me real quick so I don't sound so weird. ACN, what's up? Lita, good to see you. Gavin, what is up? This is kind of a weird thing. I'm streaming from my OBS and all that, and it's just streaming straight to IRP. The weird thing is I can't see chat in my OBS, so I have to pull up like the stream manager on Twitch to do all this stuff. So it's kind of interesting to do it. I feel a little bit off the A game here, but it's okay. We're here. Working on getting my laptop working properly. Well, hopefully you do. So I have to watch both chat, which is on the stream manager, and then my Streamlabs OBS. I can't see the chat. No, I cannot see the chat because it's technically, I'm still technically streaming on my account. I'm not streaming on Infinite RP's account. I'm just have a stream key that I'm streaming on behalf of them, kind of thing. It's weird. I don't know what's going on. But we're here, you know, and that's what matters. It's working. And we have all your lovely faces here. So, we're going to get right into it, everybody. If you have not watched The Lost City of Adranus episodes 1 and 2, first of all, what are you doing? Go watch it. It's amazing. You can stay here if you want. I'm just joking. But you should really go watch it. Check out the YouTube or the VODs. So this will have some potential spoilers. Just so you guys are aware, I'm sure some of you have watched the previous iteration of Behind the Screen before I had a name, like last week or whatever, are aware of this. I try not to reveal too much as far as spoilers go, because I want you viewers to be surprised just as much as the players are. But as far as some things, there will be some stuff that is unavoidable. But that's okay, just so you know. And if you guys ever have any questions, I wholeheartedly welcome them. So throw all the questions my way if that's something that you're wanting. I'm trying to think if there's anything else, but I don't think so. So we're going to hop right into it. So I'm going to pull up my notes real quick. You can't see it because my big head's in the way. We can move it over here. There we go. Okay. So we have to do session 3. We're going to set some goals, for this session, so we kind of know what we need to do, things we need to figure out and stuff like that. Session 3, I don't know what the name is yet. Something about doctors, something about chirurgeon, I would assume. I don't actually know. To be determined. There we go. Okay, so goals, or to-do list. I've been setting up a to-do list, and that really kind of helps me narrow my focus on what I need to work on. We need to do, obviously, the number one priority is getting the encounter done that the players so happily ran into. Nock just kind of barreled his way into this encounter with the Chirurgeon. Those of you who are not familiar, the Chirurgeon are the plague doctors from the Old Croak Market that they had an encounter with earlier on in the session, and were told not to come between them and the citizens of the Old Croak Market, whether they were sick or not. The Chirurgeon kind of have they're kind of a culty doctors union, to put it lightly, I guess. And so they came to a little area, and the players were trying to figure out what the heck was going on, because they heard like a woman screaming. Come to find out that the group of Chirurgeon that they had come across earlier, a night or two prior, were trying to separate a mother and their child because their mother was displaying symptoms of plague. And Nock, our wondrous barbarian, just ran straight in, essentially just starting this encounter without much say-so from his party members, which I'm really interested to see what happens there. So we need to do the Kyrogen encounter. That's not how you spell that. So Kyrogen encounter is pretty important. We need to do a couple lore items, which are the Kyrogen syringe and I'm trying to think of a name for the child that so Wisp got the journal from that child that she was reading on her watch and kind of learned that the Kyrogen also separated a mother from her children or one of her children. And so she has that journal, and I want to essentially what I want to do with that is I want to create a story hook with that. So she's going to have that in her inventory that can maybe proc a side quest or something like that. They want to try to track down this child. That music just got super intense. Yeah, the book. So I should have a plague doctor draft to show you later tonight too, by the way. Ooh, Gavin coming in clutch as always. I'm excited to see it. So the journal, I want to come up with a name. The lost child is diary. I don't know, the lost child's diary. That's something I need to come up with. I really think that's what we have to work with, at least for now. Because we did a lot of the other prep earlier on last week, expecting them to get to the encounter that I had prepped, but that didn't happen because they got scared because of a crow. That's also, I want to create lore around the birds because I have an idea because I think that's cool. I want to take what they found with that crow and kind of actually push a little bit of lore or something. Like, there's a reason that these birds are around and whatnot, that like they're kind of what's the word I'm even thinking of? Like a symbol or a omen of some sort. So whenever the players see it, it will, or like see a crow, it will kind of be a hey, pay attention kind of thing. So that's kind of what we're looking at right now. So let's get right into it. I'm gonna create a new map. I don't know how big we need this yet, but essentially we need to make the little homestead. I think this is 30 by 30. No, it's way more than 30 by 30. Okay, so that's quite big. We might be okay. I have some stuff that I might want to use already, but I don't want to reuse too much. So I think we have, is it this one? This is the tower, which we don't need. That's what we purchased recently. Medium city, village to pillage. I think this is what we want. A portent. Yes, 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 yes. That's a good word for it. So the problem is it's a very similar battle map to the wretched crawler, the stegocentipede that we did last week. So I don't want to copy this exactly. What I think I might do is want like more of an open square. And I know there is one, but I also have one for another encounter, which I don't want to use if I can help it. So we might just go and create something So I have something like this already as an encounter, but this is kind of semi-perfect. What we can do, I don't know if the characters will ever come across that creature. Oh my god, I also have it for another one. I have, like, the problem with using the same assets is they're the same and they're repetitive. So we might have to look for some new assets, which is perfectly fine. So I'm just going to kind of scroll through and figure out what we have. Yeah. First of all, I want to look and see if we have a Plague Doctor. We need to have some Plague Doctor tokens up in Dith. Oh, that is crazy. More assets. Okay, let's see. Well, this is... Oh my god. Maybe I should just go Doctor. That might help narrow the search a bit. Someone's had to make... Yes. Yes, 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 yes. Cultist Plague Doctor, even. Ooh, baby. Which one do we like best? The 8-bit ones? I can also make something like this pretty easily. A rat Plague Doctor. That would be interesting. We might also... Depending on where Gavin gets, and this is no way saying that you're under pressure to get it done, Gavin, but we could also make our tokens with the art that Gavin has, which would be interesting. So we could do that, but I think for now, I love all the art. I think one of these top ones is going to be really good. So this one, I think this one's like looking the best, to be perfectly honest. Let's see what else is included in here. Because if we're gonna spend some money... Oh my god, Cthulhu is in here? I have to buy it. I have to. Oh, a Gibbering Mouther? Grim Reaper? Ooh, a Mimic? I like the Plague Doctor one, too. Those aren't bad. We're gonna just spend the whole... session doing something like this. Okay, so these are just... Ooh. These are like halfway okay. What's this one? We might just have to wait. I do like these, though. But they're not top-down. They're like straight on, and I don't like that. Necessarily. Elven Plague Doctor. These are cool as fuck. Look at all the doctor things that we have. Yo, Jaden, what's going on, dude? I'm out of the loop, I guess. Are you streaming D&D now? Yes. We have 2 episodes out, which you would be familiar with because you played in the West March's Lost City of Adranus. I have turned the Lost City of Adranus into a actual campaign that's not like a West March style campaign. So I've used a lot of the same lore and things that you may have already seen for the first couple sessions. So yeah, the first 2 episodes are here on Infinite RP, on the VODs, and on YouTube. And we stream every Thursdays at 6 hour time. So it's been awesome. Yeah, it's super cool. It's been so much fun. Sucks. I don't know if I like this one that much. Is it worth it to drop that 5 bones on it? Let's see if there's any like just free shit. I don't think there will be. See if any. I don't think I even own anything that would work. You ever stream on your other channel, or are you mostly doing this for now? I'll stream occasionally on my other channel. It really just kind of depends. I haven't really been playing anything other or doing anything other than kind of prepping for this. That's where a lot of my heart and soul has gone. So definitely mostly here. But occasionally I'll be on my personal channel occasionally for sure. Just for like random games and whatnot. But anything like Vadranus related will be here. So these ones aren't bad. Shit. I might just have to make some tokens later. I just need... Ooh, that's not bad. Let's see this. Yeah, man, you'll definitely have to catch up. I'm interested to see what, like, everybody thinks and whatnot about it, so... You definitely have to let me know what you think. I wish I could see these a little bit better. Oh, there we go. Ooh. That's not terrible. Is there some, is that open? Is there like a block that's like open? I need like a square, like a town square type thing. Erg. Just a bunch of buildings. This is the one thing that like always gets me a little like semi like the most difficult thing about freaking map making online is I feel like sometimes I'm limited into what I have, I guess, if that makes sense. But let's use what we have, I guess. So what I can do, we can make this work. We can make this work, I think. I just want to make this, let's put it on the map. Now! Map layer, just so we can make it the right size, like that. I don't know if this is gonna work. Well, don't know if this is gonna work. Oh, that might work. Did I tell you I've been DMing for the first time recently? I think you might have mentioned that, actually. That seems off to me. I don't know if my players will know. Is it the one you're doing with your family? Or is it something different? Okay, this is too big. Okay. That'll work. For now. So it's my main group I've been playing with. I'm running Tomb of Annihilation for them. Ooh. Interesting. Okay. I've never ran a published adventure before. I've always done homebrew. Let's get some of these in here. We're just gonna kind of throw some assets out here. I kind of want a path like coming down. I don't know if there's like just a straight path. We could figure something out though. And these are supposed to be like pretty small homes, because they're in a pretty shitty part of town. I never played one before either, so that's something new as well. Going pretty well. Hell yeah! That's exciting. Okay, that's probably good for now. Let's see if there's like a road. which I think there's some just assets. See, like, this one would be really good for what I want, but I'm using that somewhere else. That's a door, right? These are all doorways, which we can use later if we need to. Yeah, we can just add... Okay, here we go. Yeah, this is what I want. Just, like, shit like this. I don't know. Is that gonna work? It might look kind of shitty. I guess we can do one of the nicer roads. Are you using purchase packs in Roll20? Yeah, I will randomly purchase stuff as I see fit. So, some of them are. This one specifically is, so. Is that in the middle? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. No. That won't work. So do something like that, but then we'll get... You gotta be kidding me. This is where you have to get kind of scrappy with the thing, you know? Whatever, it doesn't have to be perfect. I've been using a program called Dungeon Draft, and it's been really nice for map making. That might be something I might need to look into, is like different like programs and stuff like that to create my maps. So far, it hasn't been terrible. So we can add some of this to make it to like, yeah. I like that. I want a well as well. I guess I could have just used one of these. I will. We're fine. So kind of what I imagine is like this small, you know, square of homes, and again, this isn't going to be perfect to my vision, but it'll be something. So I just want that. I don't want the whole thing. That's what sucks, is like I only want, I swear I have something that will work too. Is it in the sewer? I think the sewer just has grates. We're down to the... Yeah. I mean, that could actually work, honestly. Like, one of these could actually work very easily. Let's throw this down. Oh no. That could work. It's really nice for creating randomly scattered items, furniture, and even making cliffs and stuff. I got it for like 60 bucks on Humble Bundle if you're interested. Ooh. I'll definitely have to check that out. That sounds super interesting. So I don't want it to be a grate. I want it to be a well. Okay, that'll work. Dirt. Which one, dirt? It's really just want like patches of dirt or something. But nothing that looks fabricated. I have an idea. Nope. That is not what I wanted. Oh, the joy of map making. You gotta love it. I'm thinking of like using something like this. I wonder if we can make it like bigger. That maybe? It might just look too shitty. Fuck! Fuck! Okay, what we have to do is go to back. I just want something like square. Oh, that's exactly what I wanted. Wonderful. This needs to go to front. Okay, and then we'll just like maybe have some. I don't know. It's supposed to be longer. Yeah, it's supposed to be a little bit longer, isn't it? Ugh. Not what I wanted. Okay. You know what? Give me a moment. Let's put the houses in here. And see what we can maybe get going. Because these aren't supposed to be like I said, they're not supposed to be super big houses. What we could do is like offset them a tad maybe so they're not like super plush. It's like the most. I don't like that one. I don't like these long ones. Because then we can like add this stuff to it as well. Yo, Brick, what is up? Thank you for the raid. How's everybody doing? Welcome, welcome. You're in the midst of me trying to do my best to make a damn map. Make a damn map. As D'Lo Brown, Derek, or Nock would say. How's everybody doing? I love you, but I'm gonna dip so I don't see too much. That is perfectly fair. That is just fine. Thank you so much for the raid. That's super awesome of you still. Yeah, it's not much to look at right now. I'm literally creating what you guys are like seeing and where you're at right now. So with the assets that I have. Maybe use that somewhere. I kind of want to. See, that's the problem. It's like, it wants it to be this. I need more buildings. Ooh, I kind of like that, actually. I wanted there to be more dirt, because I don't see it being that green, you know? And that, I don't know, it's supposed to be not as fancy as that, but we work with what we got, chat. One thing I actually need to do is I need to bring their tokens over, because I'll have all the lighting, because it is nighttime, which we need to remember. So don't let me forget that it's nighttime, chat. It is nighttime here. Yeah, we'll just like throw random assets and shit in here at some point too. That's not a bad one. It's not a bad one. Oh God, I feel like I'm playing like Minecraft or something as well, like trying to make all this work. let me move the well. I don't want the well to be at the. It would be at the center, but like I don't know if I want it to be at the center, if that makes sense. Just because I can put more stuff in here like this. And I want there to be a mishmash of different buildings and such. To just give it that air of it's not like you know, it's not going to conform or anything like that. That makes any sort of lick of sense. I feel like I'm just rambling at this point. It's the same one. I don't need that. Make them work for it. Move the well inconveniently. That's kind of what I was thinking. It needs to be inconveniently placed, so they have to work around it, right? Which I'm going to add other buildings. Like, they're going to be, I want them to be fighting in between, so, you know. Yeah. Put that right here. It's not a well, but I don't want to spend $5 on an asset. Or one asset, so. We could put fences and walls and things. I don't know. Put in a square like fenced off? Yeah, we could do that. It's not a bad idea. I don't like that one. See, this one's not bad. I can make it smaller too, right? What is it? Oops. You're not a token, though. Why are you giving me the token shit? I don't know. I don't know what I'm doing. We're just winging it. Okay, we can put other shit around, too. I kind of want to put, like, a carriage somewhere in the way. Ooh, what is this stuff? Mansion of Mystery? I don't even remember buying that one. Broken cart, there we go. There we go. This is something we could use. Because my the way I imagine it, just throw that sucker on there. Just leave that there for now. We could just have a flaming one. Do we want it on fire? Doesn't make sense, but okay. We got stuff to work with. I need to come over here. And I need to go to the token layer and select all these guys and bring them over here. Okay, so these guys are all off in their own direction. I'm gonna say knock is like, where should I make it? I don't want him to make it so he can't just run straight there, right? Maybe we'll put, I don't know, we'll figure something out. So what we need to do is we need to think about lighting. I'm trying to think. I know I have some civilian, like just regular assets like that somewhere. I think they're in the free ones? Character. Excuse me, soldier. I just want a person. You know, townsfolk. Here we go. God, these are such like. Oh, there's a child right there. I don't want you holding anything. Okay, that's a kid. There we go. That's the child that the doctors are after. The art is just all over the place. There's no exact rhyme or reason for it. Sure. Sure. She's right here. Let's put her over here. Let's put them over here. Trying to think. We just need a bad guy. This. Nothing we need right now. Soldiers. Again, they're doctors, but that's not the right kind of soldier. That is the wrong time period. That's like Fallout. Do I... I can make some tokens. Let me make a... Let me find some art real quick. I don't know if it's okay to do this, but we're gonna do it anyway. Not an exact replica of the plague doctors we're working with, but it'll work. The thing I want... That'll work. Oh, creepy music. Need to make two. Token maker. Whoop. Bring this guy over here. And I want one of them, I want the border tint to be like a purple. Because that's what color their lenses are. Like this kind of deep purple. And then the other one we'll do, I want it to be red to signify he's like a boss, I guess. So it'll stand out a bit. Okay, got those. Put down. Drag these over here. Oh my god, they're huge. Okay. So my thinking is the red one is the leader who actually the leader is the one who helped the party originally. Let's just drag three more of these because there's four of them, which I stated earlier. I'm gonna put one out here. We're gonna find a place to put these. They're pretty close together. The one thing we need, cats just did something. There is a darkness aura around them. So what we need to do is go to D&D Beyond. I need to look at the darkness spell because Wisp cast darkness right on that guy. It's a 15-foot radius. Okay. Cool. So what we can do is this tint, we can make it dark, 15, and we'll make it so you can see it. So essentially everybody here is in this darkness. We want it darker. How does that look? And what is magical darkness spreads from a point you choose to fill a 15-foot radius sphere for the duration. The darkness spreads around corners. A creature with dark vision can't see through this. So that's the important part that I don't know if the players thought about. So Nock is running into this fray, right? And we might even move it over here. We might add some more houses. Nock is running into this fray. He's running right into darkness. He's not going to be able to see either. They are also exhausted. They got one level of exhaustion. So they're not their attacks, but their skill checks are going to be at disadvantage. So it's actually going to be pretty hard for them to see as well, so it's gonna be a really interesting fight with that spell on. Non-magical light can't illuminate it. So they do have a lantern as well. I do want to emit some torches. I feel like there would be torches around here. I know I have fire assets or something. Yes, see, I have, there we go. So we can put these out here that will actually emit light, which will be nice. Like put it like next where the doors would be. Yeah, quite literally they'll be running blindly. And even just adding these little details will bring a lot of life into the map itself. So there is, there will, would technically be a lantern right here, but surprise, surprise, it's not doing anything. That's fine for now. So I can do this, and I can do dynamic lighting. Emits light. What does a torch emit? Is it 30 feet? 20 foot radius. And then dim light for an additional 20. So I'm just going to say these are torches, so it's... So it'd be 20 and 20, right? And then we can actually have it be directional, which would be 90, 180, oh god, 270? Is that right? I don't know if that's right. Is that right, chat? 90, 180, I don't fucking know. 260? No. 240? 320? I don't know, chat. You guys need to tell me this. Okay, so that emits light. So let's turn on the dynamic lighting. Let's just turn that on. Hide areas. Would it be? It wouldn't be explore. I don't know what we. I can't remember how we did this last time. Let me go to the Stegos Centipede encounter and look at it. 270. Thank you. It is explore darkness. Okay, let's just do that. Are you guys okay? I love this song. This is Castlevania main theme, right? Who is hyped for Castlevania, the new season that comes out like this week? I'm so fucking stoked. You guys have no idea. You have no idea. So stoked. Okay. What was I doing? Permanent darkness. We don't want permanent darkness. We want explorable darkness. Oh god. That was not what I wanted. I haven't seen it yet, which is a damn shame because I'm a sucker for vampires. Love it. It's so good, Lita. You should definitely watch it. You can actually get through the first three seasons relatively quickly. It's actually, they're pretty quick. It's a pretty quick showing, so. Okay, so. Total size, is that the what I want? Set the direction of the light emitting from this token. Oh, I see. Okay, let's not worry about that right now. Let me take this off. I just want it to have light. This is the grindy part of doing these freaking the DM prep. So we're gonna try to get through this like relatively quickly, so we can do some lore stuff and get some exciting things going on for you guys. So. Okay, why is it not showing? the light being emit. One thing I also want to do is we need to go to the dynamic lighting layer and we need to draw some shapes. Actually, let's do lines and then we'll do yellow. So this will be pretty easy to do, luckily. Is that what I want? Yeah, I do want that, actually. Okay, that works. I also got some Dishonored in here. I updated the playlist, so I got a little bit more, so... Just been pulled in so many directions recently. I totally feel you. I totally get that. Okay. So we're on the token layer. Have I set these vision? The vision should be set for these people. Yes. Right, okay. Let me just switch over as a player real quick. I don't know if it's gonna work, because this should be showing on my end. That's not right. We're on the wrong map. Okay, let's show this again. Huh? What is this? Oh, well, now people can see. Okay, so it seems to be working. Where the fuck did the grid go, though? Why is it hiding the grid? What in the heck? Like, it's snapping, but it's not showing the grid. That's super weird. So Nox should be, like, revealing all of this. Yeah, okay. So I'll have to reset it, but that is working now. So this should be 20 feet. Yeah, this should be all bright light. It should be illuminating. It should be illuminating all that. That looks correct to me. I just want to see it from the player's perspective. Oh god, there's some weird janky shit going on right there, but it is casting shadows, though. Which, I want to try something really quick. I don't want it to be, like, bright light for them. And I saw there's a thing that we might be able to change. Okay, so we go here, the dynamic lighting, night vision effect. I want to see what it does when we change it to nocturnal. And I can actually already see that it is changing. For some reason, it's giving us the grid. He does not have night vision. And he does not have night vision. Okay, so let's rejoin his player real quick. Water vision? Yeah. Pretty much, right? Okay, so what does that do? It is kind of janky, isn't it? But it's not, I don't know, it's not terrible, I guess. Yeah, it's just, I think it's just the lighting gets kind of weird right there. But that's not bad. Yeah, Vodger has like 300 feet of fucking dark vision. Like, it's nuts. Like, look at that. You can see so easily. So a knock. I can't change that, so. So knock has should not have vision. Knock should not be able to see. Right? So Nox should not be able to see anything. Let's move everybody over here and see what that looks like. And once we get the map made, we can get into the nitty gritty of... Yeah, Nox is like, See, it's not revealing any light. Which is how it should be, I think. Like, even if we move all these guys up, like, here, where they wouldn't be able to see. I just lost Nock, but that's fine. Where is he? Oh, here he is. Is that what we want? Yeah, Nock is blind. Like, straight up blind. Running in here, and he'll be even more blind. Well, it shouldn't be that dark. He should have low light vision or something, I feel. That's the child. I don't want to move the child. He should be able, I mean, he has to be able to see, so I have to have vision on. Limit field of vision. Total size. Well, he should be able to see 360. Right? If he can't see in the dark, that's accurate. Is there a torch or any source? Yes, there is. And for some reason, I don't know if they're working. I think they're working. What are you doing, buddy? Because these should be emitting light. Which we can turn them down if we need to. But these torches should be emitting some sort of light. Which I'd have to... But he should still be able to see his where, right? He should be able to see at least a few feet, like a foot in front of him. So that's where I'm wondering if I need to give him vision. Otherwise, like, he's legit going in blind. So I guess that's one thing I need to think about as I'm doing this. But let's move everybody over here. So this should be emitting light. So these torches are not doing what they should be doing. So we need to figure that out. Do I have to give them vision, maybe? But that's on, so... What if I did this? Just give it full 360, maybe? Okay, where's... Things are getting all strewn about. What it actually should do. Let's, if we move everybody over here, I need to see. I'm just gonna do this for now. Actually, let's do this, because that should give me Soul control of our boy. And then we can rejoin. All the advanced lighting things are stuff I've not played with with Sword and Little Hope. No, you're okay.
Appreciate it.
Yeah, it's super new to me as well. There we go. Okay, so it is. Okay, that's now working. So I can see that that light is doing what it should be. So Calder can see in here, but like once he gets past this light, like he can't see anything. Which, okay, so that looks accurate. That's just because of... Good God. What is this? Is that just... I think that's still the light shining out. That looks wrong. Because that's 20 feet right there of light. But then it should be another 20 feet of dim light. And then there should be the one over here. So if Calder comes here, I feel like move them all so they're like hidden to not see there. Yeah, so Calder should be able to see that. That looks like it's working. There's just this weird little... No, that looks accurate. Okay. It's so weird just having all the players' vision, like, because these guys have night vision galore, right? So it's just like kind of weird to play with the lighting, but that looks good to me. I'm not gonna worry about the dim light. I mean, that's probably accurate. It's probably working right. Okay, so we've got that figured out. And if I need to give any of them night or dark vision later, that'll be really easy to change. So that's fine. What we're gonna do real quick is I'm just gonna add two torches here. And that should keep all of those settings for me. So there's the darkness right here centered on this guy. Which technically they'd also be carrying a lantern. Which is going to be kind of weird. So he's technically emitting bright light as well because he's got a torch, but we can't really see that. So that's fine. I just want to go and add some more derfs. So let's bring all these guys. Not that. Mother trucker, get out of here, you stupid. Is that why? Is that a... Get on the map, Lair. What are you doing here? Get on the map, Lair. That's why. Okay. Now that we've got that sorted. I don't know where everybody's gonna be placed. I know we can add more houses over here. We can change all that shit. Nock is gonna be, I wanna say Nock's like right here. Or maybe they're not even coming from this direction. Because we can yeah. I'm gonna maybe orient the map a little differently. Not exactly, but like I just want to have this. Because I can kind of see them running in this direction, which might be kind of awkward. Six, one, two, three, four, five, six, that works. And then this little guy, we'll go right here, and then we'll just use that to meld into that. Okay, so go back to where you were. That is accurate. Okay, we're done messing with that. Nock is gonna be running right into these guys, because that's how I kind of imagine this looking. I actually also wanna do this. That will also go on the map layer. Just little touch-ups. Okay, so Alder and Kimura aren't even like on the map, so that's the thing. Everybody is gonna be a turn or so away because Nock just ran so fast into his own, you know, on his own. So it's gonna take. I will determine. So they're like still like a good like quarter mile away. I'm gonna say where Nock is. I'm just gonna say he's there. Like Nock is right here. These guys are gonna be two turns away. It's not how you spell that. Kyrogen encounter. Nock will start 30 feet away. Rest of. I'm gonna say. Wisp and Water. And I might let them decide. Essentially. Mora and Calder are. I'm gonna say they have to be 60 feet away because Wisp did cast the darkness spell. So at least Wisp and Vodder will be 60 feet away. Kamor and Calder, if depending on immediately if like the encounter starts, I'll let them kind of decide if they get a little bit closer together. Just because it is the first combat encounter of the campaign, and I don't want it to be super super difficult. I will be interested to see if other players can see the light. Let's do Kyrogen two. I just want to put these guys' name down. Kyrogen four. And this will be the Kyrogen leader. So they can determine that. That will work. Let's put some more houses down. This is also going to help with line of sight stuff. So we do like something like this, and then we can just turn and put it in a different direction. This we'll have to go to the front. We put a broken down wagon like halfway through. That'll work. Oops. Place this one too somewhere. Again, it doesn't need to be perfect. It just needs to look like a cluster of homes, mainly just for lighting and shit. I honestly don't think the fight's gonna progress much farther than right here. So honestly, we'll probably be okay. Does that on off-road. It's acting kind of funky. Okay, just real quickly, we'll go back to the dynamic lighting layer and just add some. We'll just add some of this lighting here. It's not perfect, but it's okay. So weird that that stuff goes away. We go to the map background and we can add more lighting. so that'll help even more. So, okay. Honestly, that's probably like all I need. Like, I don't really want to fuck with it that much more. It doesn't need to be that big, right? I don't need to go into full detail. I think that looks good enough for what we want. Oh fuck, something moved. Is it this one? There we go. Okay, that's fine. So what we need to do now is I need to come up with stats for these guys. And yeah, we'll do that. I had an idea that they'd be cultists. So cult fanatic. And let's go to Kobold Fight Club. So we got 5 level 3s. So cult fanatic. And then 3 of these. That's a medium encounter. I don't want this to be a difficult encounter. This is a semi-random encounter. Not super, super random, but semi-random, right? Is dark also what to... Goodness, is darkness a concentration spell? It is, okay. So, one thing we need to know is Wisp needs to focus on this darkness spell. If she casts any other spells or anything like that, she needs to make a concentration check. Wisp is casting darkness on the Kyrogen leader. Yeah, it was a fun little challenge. More so, though, my thoughts behind this encounter are the consequences of the encounter, not the encounter itself. So, as we can imagine, the Kyrogen are taking this child because she's displaying symptoms of plague. They are separating her from her mother, right? But they are doing it for technically a... in their mind, a good reason to protect the mother and the child by separating them so the mother doesn't get sick. If she's not already, we don't know that, actually. The Kyrogen have told the party, these four guys have told the party to not come between them and their work, which Nock is doing right now. So it's more so the consequences. The Kyrogen, in my mind, were potentially not necessarily an ally, but someone that the party could work with, and they are also a quest giver. They also gave them a side quest. If you remember, Vodder was like, hey, we have a friend. Do you know if anybody could, you know, help him in response to Kyron? And this leader said, yeah, bring him to the asylum and we'll look at him. That's probably, depending on how this works out, that's out of the question. They might not be able to do that anymore because they're attacking these guys. One thing I need to think of, is if they kill all of them, does word get back? How does it get back? But on one hand, is this mother gonna be happy that these random people just came in and killed these doctors who were gonna help? The doctors were going to try their best to help this child. What is the mother going to think if they killed these doctors? Yes, the doctors were taking their child, but now their child is really helpless. They are very far away from the asylum. If we go to the map... So, this is where the party is right here. This is the asylum. That's almost a week away. Even if they try to take her to the market, which they don't know necessarily where the market is, that's 2 days away as well. And if we go back to our old plague, the onset is 3 days. So it's already been 3 days and she's displaying symptoms. So I'm thinking she's got a bad headache and a runny nose. That's her first stage. Two, so a couple more days, she's going to have a body ache. She's going to be struggling. 3 more days, she'll have a terrible fever and hallucinations. She can't move by herself, so the party will literally have to move her. That's 6 days just to get her to the asylum, and she's in that state already. You know? And if they lollygag and decide not to travel a day to take on the wretched crawler, they're dropping that mission to go and do this, which is fine, but that's, you know, another thing. She's gonna, like, this child is now in danger, you know, because for the Kyrogen, it's easy. They know where to go. It's easy to take her to the market and help her, and the doctors have ways to like kind of help. They don't know everything about the plague, but they know enough to keep people okay. It's gonna, decisions have consequences, 100%, and Vodder might be able to help. I think Vodder is one of the only people that can help this, this child. If he took the proper, if he has the proper spells with him, which we don't know. I guess I can check that, right? Because if he has like some restoration spells and some healing spells, he can, but he is using those spells. He is using his resources to do that, to take care of this child when he can't rest and get those spells back until a long rest, which to get a long rest in this system, he has to travel, he has to rest a week. So and all like a week of downtime. So he would have to go back to Hallow. They would have to travel another 3 days for him to get those spells back, you know, and who knows what changes. We don't know. He has cure wounds, which could help. Purify food and drink could maybe help. If they have food, what if they run out of food? I don't know if they will, but they could. Sleep could also help, putting her to sleep. It looks like he does have lesser restoration, so that's going to be the spell that's going to help her most, is lesser restoration. Because if we look at it, you touch a creature, and either one disease or one condition afflicting it, the condition can be blind to stuff and paralyzed or poisoned. It's not going to get rid of this disease though. Just so we're aware. So, but it's more, yeah, again, it's the consequences of the fight, and what happens is it's going to be really interesting. This fight is not supposed to be difficult, so I'm just really excited to see what they decide to do. So it's not supposed to be that difficult. So what we'll do is we've got the cult fanatic, and then we'll also need just the regular cultist. And so I'll just have to have these stats up. Hi, buddy. You just bamf right in here. So yeah, the cult fanatic will have some spells, so that's good. So let's do this really quick. So he's got 13 armor class and 33 hit points. And he's got an AC of 13. We want to see this visible to everyone. So we should be able to see his health. And then the cultists are at 12 and 9. That's wrong. Armor class of 12, 9 hit points. So again, these guys are going to be super easy. I mean, they are doctors, right? They are not mean lean fighting machines. so it should be an easy fight, but it's, like I said, I'm really excited to see, like, how the party's gonna react to Nock just running in like this, because that's not what they had planned. Because Vodder and Wisp were trying to be silent, and Nock just kind of decided to Leroy Jenkins his way in. So that's those stats. I mean, these civilians don't have much. But there's that. So encounter should be easy. It is the consequences that are important. There is also a character that I want to try to introduce. Named Aedrid. Aedrid is a minor character. At least for the Old Crope market, he has potentially a bigger part to play in a different district. His story is in a different district, but he is here. So my thinking is, this woman's not going to be happy. Mother will not be happy about the violence. And also think that, like, these are civilians, right? They're going to see these guys destroy and just decimate these doctors. It's not going to be pretty, and they might be doing it. They're going to be doing it right in front of this family. If anything, like, the darkness will disappear, and all of a sudden you just see these dead fucking doctors. Like, that's terrifying to a normal person. So this woman is not going to give them quarter. And I'm going to say all the other homes are locked, because there are people in them. So unless they try to force their way in, and all other homes will be locked. No one will let them in. The only person who will let them in is Aedrid, and he is up in this home right here. He is the only one who will give them quarter. And there are multiple reasons for that, mainly because he's probably seen this before. He's seen stuff like this, and obviously I want to push that potential for that character introduction, so there's that. We also have to remember that the players are very tired and probably getting hungry, right? So if we look at, like, I wonder if Derek did it. So they're sleepy, thirsty, and hungry. I think somebody's here. Hello. Hello, Justin. How are you? Oh, I love it. We have to remember that the party's very sleepy. They have one level of exhaustion, so their skill checks are at disadvantage. I don't think that's going to come into play right here. Actually, now that I'm thinking about it, a concentration check is a skill check. So Wisp, if she gets attacked, she will have disadvantage on her concentration spell, on her concentration check to keep the darkness up. So there's that. My name isn't Justin, it's Dustin. I'm leaving for real. Have fun. Thanks for tuning in for a second, dude. Hope you have a good night. Oh, that's funny. So yeah, there's that. So I think we've got that sorted. Did I get the dynamic lighting on this? No. Let's just do that real quick. On this house, just cause this one's dark. I'm not even gonna wait. That's not what I wanted. Come on. All right. Am I moving shit that I don't want to move? What did I ruin? Hopefully nothing. We'll find out on Thursday. Don't look like it was actually removing anything, so we're fine. Okay. So yeah. I think that's good. I think that's the encounter, right? That's not going to be that difficult. I want to keep this stuff up because it's just going to be easy for me to cast into roll 20. So things to keep in mind, at least for the leader. And eventually, depending on what happens, we might change the Kyrogen a little bit to make them their own monster. Right? But I think for now we don't need to worry about that, because I think the Cult Fanatic works for what the Kyrogen are. So he can cast Light, which doesn't help him now. So maybe he's not holding a lantern, but he's holding a light in his hand. So he's got Sacred Flame, which is a cantrip, Command, which would be interesting if the players did not fight immediately and kept him alive. That could be interesting if that happens. He's got Inflict Wounds. He has to be right there onto somebody, next to somebody. He's got Shield of Faith. Old Person. Choose a humanoid that you can see, so he cannot cast that, unfortunately, because he can't see, because otherwise he'd try to hold Knock in place. Spiritual Weapon is huge. He could do Spiritual Weapon. But, okay. I think we've got that. That is settled and good. What we need to work on now is the lore items. So let us go. So we've got the Cravens. That's not one you can see. A new page below that. We'll make that a sub page. So I've got the Kyrogen's syringe and the Lost Child's diary. This diary. We'll do these. Let's see. I want it to be. Again, it's got to be. This one's a little bit of a plot hook, a little bit of a story hook. This diary recounts of a young boy from the old Croak Market. His father left. Father left, leaving the family alone. Sometime later, boy's mother came sick with plague. The Kyrogen came and took her and the boys. Baby. Words. Infant. Infant sister. Left alone in his home. I don't know if the lost child is like a good word. Like, I don't want to be the lost child. Left alone, the boy set off into the market alone, searching for his father. Okay, so that's something. The lost child. We can really create something cool with this. Because how long ago was this? You know, how long ago did this happen? We don't know necessarily. One thing I've tried to impart, I guess, is that time is strange in Vedranas. So it might have been 100 years to everybody, all the players, but it might not have been 100 years to anybody else. I want to create a story behind this. I want this to be a story that is potentially looked into. So I want to create a villain or some. I want this to be a very tragic story. NPCs, villains. None of those would work. Maybe Father Godwin. Let's see. So this is the fantasy name generators. Super, super useful. I use this quite a bit, so. So what could have happened to this boy? Do we want him to be alive still? Did he perish? 7 or 8 year old, man, that's pretty tough to survive in this city during this whole thing, right? So, I can make a note. Let me look at the map again. We can essentially add a new thing here, can't I? Can add something to the map. I don't know if I'm kind of scared to add too much to the map, but we could add something. Anyway, okay. So what would have happened to this boy? He probably would have gotten sick, honestly. Like, if his mother was sick, he probably would have gotten sick. I have an idea. Have an idea. And it's gonna help me push more story. So he doesn't have a name. Do I have a color for random encounters? I don't think so. So that signifies a dungeon. That is a Lorne thing. That is something else. Green is a something else. Purple is a bounty. Red is a district specific thing. Yeah, exactly. Lita, you might understand this. So, when someone gets sick from this plague, they don't necessarily die. They turn into something. So I'm gonna say that this happened to this child. So if the players ever come, sorry, goodness, if the players ever come across them, they will see what happens if you leave someone who doesn't get, like, leave someone. I don't want to, that's super, because that's also very spoilery for the campaign. So I'm not going to go into too much detail until the players get there. And I need to create stats for this as well, because the stats that I have in the book, it's way too difficult to fight. So I don't want to, I don't want to do that one immediately. I'm not saying anything. Yes. Okay. So I think we can call it the Lost Child. The Lost Child. And the thing is, the players will have the Lost Child's diary. Or I don't want to call it the Lost Child. I want a different word for lost. Like the wayward child or something like that. You guys can help me think of this shit too. So if you have any ideas, throw them my way. But essentially the name of the thing that they fight, if they find it, will be the same name as the diary. So the players will be like, oh my God, if they catch it. So the blank child was once a young boy in the Old Crook Market. But after I'm trying to think of the words. Unfortunately, he never found what he was looking for. He soon succumbed to plague and became a blank. Hint, hint. So this is to do two things. So this character is to show you, the players, what happens when the plague, when someone succumbs to the plague and does not get the help that the Kyrogen do provide. But it's also to show that the Kyrogen are not perfect, obviously, because they will abandon people. Or they will tear apart families to help people who are sick. Not keeping in mind that the other person can get sick, right? And so this is like a twofold, like, kind of a sad story where this child got left on his own for how long, we don't know. First abandoned seemingly by their father, and then the Kyrogen took his mother from him. And his infant sister. So he set out to find his father because he thinks that's the only thing he can do. But it's this 8-year-old boy trying to navigate through this giant market during a plague. He's scared of Kyrogen because they're the ones who took him, or took his mother. So he's afraid of them, and he succumbs to his sickness alone, maybe, and becomes this thing. You think wayward is a good word? I like wayward. The wayward child. I like that. Wayward child's diary. This diary recounts the life of a young boy from the Old Cork Market. His father left abandoned his family. leaving them to fend for themselves. What I'm trying to provoke is that there is a world and there are lives going on in this world that the players have no say in sometimes. There's a living world that is breathing around them, whether they're there or not, and this stuff is kind of to try to help reinforce that thought. So is it the boys? Mother became sick with the plague. The Kyrogen came and took her and the boys of his sister. I'm sure it's just that. Left alone, the boy set off into the market alone, searching for his father. Finally done cooking so I can be more attentive? Hell yeah. What did you cook? What we need to do is I need to create a magic item. It's not really a magic item. It is, I can't remember what I, let me look at my other things that I created. Because I have a couple other lore items. Wondrous item, very rare. Okay. Then what I can do is literally just copy and paste this in here. Chana masala, made my own Indian takeout. Hell yeah, ooh, that sounds so good. Love it. I love it. Okay. Create magic item. I think that's good enough for me. Okay, so the poison. Oh yeah, I need to do something like this. Okay. So I don't want that to actually be italicized. Tattered diary. Bit of a cheap leather. That's nice, well, foreboding. Okay. So what we have is, this diary recounts the life of a young boy from the old Croak Market. His father abandoned, so it kind of tells it, and then In the italicized words is to describe the book in and of itself. So the Tattered Diary is made of a cheap leather. The words are misspelled and the handwriting is that of an 8-year-old boy. There are no dates, only the foreboding tale of a child who may to this day be lost in the city of Adranus.
Does that get the point across? Is that sad?
Sure.
I spelled wayward wrong. Wayward. It came out pretty good this time. Hell yeah, I'm getting hungry. I have some loaf cake I might go grab here in a second. Okay, view magic items. So that's not what I want. Wait, why are we listening to Overwatch? I can play this on piano and I love this song, by the way. I get so happy when I hear this. This is not the music we need right now, but okay. I guess my playlist ended. We'll listen to it for a second. Okay. There's a tune I haven't heard in a million years. You know what tune that reminds me of? That tune reminds me of this. Who knows what this is from? You should know what this is from. I'll be quiet. It's from Hook. It is Hook. Okay, so it makes me think of the movie Hook. You guys are right. It is the main theme. It's the prologue theme from Hook. Anyway.
Too happy. Go away. Too happy. I don't want it.
Okay, why can't I add my homebrew item? Oh my idiot. My homebrew creations. Uh-huh. Still need to change some stuff on it.
High fives all around.
Edit. Why?
Ah!
Oh, additional information. That's probably why. Let's go there and do this. Is that gonna work? Is that sure? So why in the great world of Adranus can I not add it to her character sheet? I cheat though, I'm a huge John Williams fan, aren't we all? Wait, oh, I think I know why. Maybe. I need to go to my campaign.
Campaign!
View. Content management? No. Edit campaign? No. Why can't I add it to her character sheet? So I can't even add it. Okay, so I can't add homebrew stuff for some reason. Custom items? No, it's actually an item. Why? Oh, why? This is unfortunate. Share with community? Remember, your private homebrew collection is automatically shared with users in your campaigns. You do not need to share with the community. Okay. That's great, but why can't I add it? I should be able to search it. Oh, Jesus. Right? Unless, did she not allow homebrews? I don't know, that shouldn't be right. Can I add it to somebody else? Equipment, manage equipment. Yeah, the Wayward Child's there. Okay, so I think I need to go in and edit more, or Wisp a little bit. Homebrew content, there we go. That should work. Okay, so let me go in, let's refresh this, and let's try it again. She just didn't have homebrew content on here. I spelled Wayward again. Add. Okay, there we go. So here it is. Hell yeah, okay. Wait, so what the last or the other thing we're gonna do is the Kyrogen's syringe. So we need to create some stuff. Okay. So how did we do it? So we have the lore and then the description. So I need to think of... I need to think of something for this. Did you want a journal for the doodle? No, a doodle for the journal. No, that should be okay. I don't think we need it. Excuse me. Chirogen syringe. Only to the most senior. Of doctors. Chirogen. The syringe is presented to the elected Chirogen by Sigismund, the good doctor himself. Again, so what this is doing is this is giving lore dumps to the players so they can learn and get names and whatnot if they come across this, which by killing the leader, they will get this. The Chirogen syringe is a medical tool given to only the most senior of doctors. The syringe is presented to the elected. In a the ritual. Now this is where I need you guys' help. I'm trying to think of what this ritual could be, and it's a surgery of some caliber, right? So essentially what I'm thinking is these doctors have to go through this ritual, which is a surgery on somebody to show that they are worth being presented with this syringe, which is more of a marking of seniority than it is an actual tool. So is it a functional thing or more just a ceremonial? And they have it. Yeah, so that's exactly what it is. It's not necessarily functional. In game, it's not functional. So the players can't necessarily use it and take it and like stab somebody with it. It is quite literally a lore item or a trinket. Trinkets have value to certain people in Vedranis, but it's more just a ceremonial thing to mark their rank. Idea. I saw a picture on like Reddit of some doctor performing surgery on themselves. They had to remove their appendix by themselves. So they were sitting there doing surgery on themselves. That's fucking cool. I'm gonna use that. So the ritual. Let's see. Is there something in the vial, perhaps, or there once was, and now only dried remnants? Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. The blood of the doctor, to which it's given, or perhaps even a bit of Sigismund. Ooh, yeah, that could be interesting. That could be really interesting. So, yeah, so the ritual itself is a surgery performed. I'm trying to think of how to word this. Into the medical tool given to the most senior doctors. It is a mark of seniority amongst the Chirurgeon. Actually, a mark of rank? Surgeon, there it is. The syringe is presented to the elected Chirurgeon by Sigismund the Good Doctor himself in a herring. Which should it be a herring himself? Is that right? The ritual itself is a surgery that is that the Chirurgeon must perform on themselves. They are tasked. The syringe contains a... Oh, what's the word I'm trying to think of? I can't word today. That's what I'm thinking. What I'm thinking is there some sort of painkiller? So they're given, they're like, hey, you have to do the surgery on yourself. Here is your syringe. And so the syringe has like morphine or some sort of painkiller in it that they can use on themselves during their trial, essentially, or their ritual to help them along the way. And essentially how much they use will kind of dictate how well looked upon they are amongst the community of doctors. That's pretty dope as fuck. But if a doctor has an untinted barrel, then the others know they can handle the pain of what needs to be done. Exactly. I love that. The less... The less of the painkiller they use, the higher they are looked upon by their colleagues. Is that how you spell? Oh, colleagues. Okay, so let's read this. The Chirurgeon's syringe is a medical tool given to only the most senior of doctors, or only the most proven of doctors. It is a mark of rank amongst the Chirurgeon. The syringe is presented to the elected Chirurgeon by Sigismund the Good Doctor himself in a harrowing ritual. The ritual itself is a surgery that the Chirurgeon must perform on themselves. This music is making it epic as fuck. They are tasked to remove some organ. An organ of their choosing. syringe contains a painkiller that the doctor can use during their own surgery. The less of the painkiller they use, the higher they are looked upon by their colleagues.
That's metal as fuck. I love it.
Let me make sure I'm not stealing something from. And now you get to decide how much this doctor they obtained it from. Yeah. He's not super high on the list, so I feel like. Contains a small amount of yellowish liquid. This intricate syringe is made of metal and glass. The point's still sharp enough to draw blood. Inside the vial contains a small amount of yellowish liquid. That bubbles when held still. How does that sound? Also, Gavin, can I show the art? Are you cool if I show the sketch that you made? I know it's not like the line art hasn't been done on it or whatever. Are you good if I share that art? Hell yeah. Awesome. Joe's life, how's it going? It's going really good. I've been having a lot of fun prepping this session. How's it going for you? I always forget. No, you're good, dude. Yeah, let me show you what the syringe actually looks like. If I can zoom out. So that's the syringe right there. So this is going to be on the loading screen for the intermission screen and the starting soon screen. So I love it. It looks so fucking good. Good, just got home from D&D night. Hell yeah. How's your campaign going? What do you guys what's up with your campaign? Like, what's the story going on right now? Yeah, I'm excited to see the finished product. So yeah, I guess Gavin, the liquid inside would be yellowish. That's my detail for you, I guess. So we need to make another item real quick. We'll create from scratch. This whole aesthetic is my jam. I love it. It's so much fun. It's a wondrous item. And then what we'll do is we should just have to copy and paste that here. And then we should just have to add like this other part, right? I'm trying to figure out how this one was done. I guess I could just look at it. Yeah, it's just like, okay. Your character backstory was just revealed. That's always a fun time when that happens. Okay, so what we need to do... We need to go back to my homebrew creations real quick, and we need to look at this. I don't want that node there. I want it like that. So let's go to the Wayward Child's Diary and just, we'll fix this real quick. What was the reaction like to your party? Like, is it like a super surprising backstory or? Okay. So if we go back to my creations right here. So I've got that. That looks good. And then this should be good. Okay, awesome. So as far as our to-do list, the Kyrgyz encounter is done. The lore items are done. So we need to create lore around the ravens and crows. That's kind of the plan right now. So we'll work on that for... time is up. We'll work on that for a little bit. We'll probably go for another 45 minutes, and that's probably where we will call it some. I'm a bounty hunter hunting the party that the DM okayed. I made my character to force more in-character conversations. I'm a changeling 7th level Echo Knight Fighter, 6th level Trickery Domain Cleric. Ooh, that is interesting. I don't think I've ever played any character like that. That is interesting. I love changelings though. I've had a couple of changeling NPCs that I have really had a fun time playing. Okay. So, give me 1 second. I'm just gonna grab a snack really quick. I need to feed my face. I'll be back in just a second. Make sure you guys join the IRP Discord if you're interested. And then if you are interested in watching the first 2 episodes of The Lost City of Adranus, make sure to check out the YouTube and the VODs. We appreciate you. I will be back in just a second. It'll literally be just a couple seconds. I just need to grab a snack. So the Changeling plus clones is super fun RP value. I'm sure that sounds super. That'd be a lot of fun to play with. I'll be right back. Snack for a second. I've got loaf cake, some vanilla loaf cake. It's really tasty. Hi, Boba. Boba wants to join the prep. Thank you, everybody, for hanging out tonight, by the way. It's been a lot of fun. I have a lot of fun doing prep. This is my second time ever streaming my prep. But I definitely notice I think I said this last time that I can focus a lot better.
Yeah, you can't have any of the cake, but...
An Echo Knight that can physically fight and a cleric clone that can cast spells is great. I know the mirror image spells and blink spells. Oh, jeez, man. That sounds crazy. What about you? I love cake. So good. We got a little boy. I'm gonna make life difficult. Hey, hop down.
You can't have cake. It's not good for you. It's not good for me. It's not good for you.
Yeah. It's not broken in combat, but might be an RP. I was gonna ask if it was like OP or anything in combat, because it sounds like it could be, but
that's really cool.
So Vedranus. It could be under lore items, or it could be under. I don't know where to put this. So essentially what we're doing now is I want to come up with a story reason that the crows are around. So if you guys missed it in the last episode, there was a crow that was in one of like the abandoned buildings that the players were scared shitless of. And so I've had an idea for crows or ravens being a thing in the campaign since we started prepping this. And then with the art that Gavin did, there's actually a crow on the fucking statue of the Sentinel. And so I want that to be a thing. So a scouting alone is sending in a clone that is a changeling is great. That sounds super interesting. That's super cool. Oh shit, there is a crow. You should know, you drew it, bro. I think I have a... Do I have an image on here? Let me add an image real quick so you guys can see it. So this is the Sentinel statue right here. So there's a little crow on it. I forgot about that. So my thing is, and I forgot to mention it during the first session, that there are like crows around. I'm thinking maybe one crow. I did it mostly for a size comparison. That's fair. I'm trying to think of a reason the crows are around, or what they mean. One idea is they're attracted to whatever is going on in the city. They're also attracted to people that are from the city. So, like, if they go back to the Sentinel's Rest, there will be a crow there hanging out on the sign because there are people like Lorne, for example, who are in there, and they'll try to get in or whatever. But it could also be, it'll potentially be more meaningful. So that's what I'm kind of thinking. If you guys have any ideas, I'm super open to it. I've ruled that my copies look like my current form as of casting the spell. Once I had my copy hold myself hostage. What the heck? For what reason? That's super interesting. ACN is here now. Not like messengers, no. Again, more like a herald of like an omen. Type of thing, right? Or a portent, like Lita said, of things. Corvids can be scavengers, but they're smart. They can recognize individuals. Who is to say that crows can't see something on folks that we don't exactly? And I don't know if you caught it, but people who... Here's a little bit of a spoiler, kind of, but it's been alluded to. People that live within Vedranus can tell if people are not from Vedranus. Like Lorne, right when the party walked in, Lorne was like, oh, hey, outsiders. And he called them outsiders, straight up outsiders. And then when they came across the Kyrogen, one of the Kyrogen tilted his head and sniffed and said, outsiders. They instantly recognize that they are not from Vedranus, and there is a reason for that. So I kind of like to think that these crows also can do that or know that, right? And so it should be hopefully a thing where people will be like, where the players can be like, oh, this person's from Vedranus because of the way they talk to us or address us or whatever. So... the Kyrogen also worship kind of the crows. I don't know if you noticed, but when they said there was a crow in the house or whatever, when the crow was mentioned or the raven was mentioned to the Kyrogen, they all bowed their heads. I don't know if you noticed that, but there's a reason for that. Lore bits, I don't know. But yeah. I want that to be a thing. The crows of Vedranus. Yeah, they definitely held their heads like in reverence for it. They're also referred to as crows too, it's like a derogatory term that some of the citizens will call the Kyrogen crows. I don't even know. And worship? Maybe? I don't know. This is why I read and don't write. I can't think of cool shit. Sometimes it just like comes to you, I don't know. And then sometimes you're trying to figure shit out and it's like, I can't think of anything. I also realize that this guy's in the fucking way. Sorry. Anyway, so that's our... There we go. There's our little sentinel. Why does he get a damn statue? I want to watch that clip. Can we take a sidebar? And watch that clip real quick? The answer is yes. Where was it? Random media? Yeah.
Not this earth no more. But I'm wondering what he did, and he was just walking over there to see if he can read the plaque.
Okay.
So who wants to know who this man is? Why the hell does he get a damn statue?
A big man wants to know why the other big men get what? Statues and he doesn't.
Oh my
God.
It's
so good. It's so good.
Anyway. There's that. So good. It's so good. The party chemistry has been super fun. I'm super excited to just see more more inter-party roleplay. Not that we haven't seen it at all, but a lot of the party has been like directly, they interact with a lot of the NPCs and not as much with themselves, at least that I've noticed. Maybe I just haven't noticed it because I'm so busy. Like when they're not talking directly to me, I'm like focusing on other things. But that might be why. But I'm super excited for this session because I feel like, you know, this is something like this encounter that they're going to be dealing with, is really going to push that. Hey, we need to talk and figure this out kind of thing. And have a conversation about how we deal with stuff. So I'm pretty excited about that. Some interesting balances and imbalances there, yeah, for sure. I also really like the clip I got with Duxon, yeah. Well, maybe if they actually listen to the crows and not kill them, perhaps they can be guides if they go off the main roads. Oh. Ooh, I'm digging that. I'm digging that. That would be interesting because I feel like they'd have to work for the crows to be able to be guides for them. Because they would only do it for people who are of Adranas. Or something like that, you know. Not direct guides, but can lead them from danger. Yeah, that's... That could be one way to go about it. I feel like Vodder would be the one to pay attention to in the first. Yeah, maybe. Yeah, and the crows are probably mad one of them didn't come home for dinner too long. Dude, bitch! Ooh. Maybe they get attacked. Maybe they get attacked by a swarm of crows. Because of that. Wisp and Kimura will just keep killing them. Yeah. What if we added another encounter for this fight? What if we added another encounter for this next session? If things are getting too easy in like the wretched crawler encounter or Oh my god. What if they are, oh my god, I just had a fucking revelation, you guys. I just had a fucking moment. Listen. The Sentinels are protecting a very specific thing. The statue, that representation is a very specific thing for Vedranus, or the lack thereof kind of thing. So we've got that thing. What if the crows protect people of Vedranus? What if that's what they do, or they try to help? So since that the party killed one of the crows and are also attacking the Kyrogen, what if a murder of crows comes to help the fucking Kyrogen? Because that's what they do, because the Kyrogen like worship them in a way. Oh my. It would be a raven, right? Would it be like a... a swarm of ravens. Monster Manual, page 339. Oh, that's way too big. Swarm of Ravens. Armor class 12. Hit points 24. 50 feet flying. Wants to be a local of Adranus, daughter of crows, just want to grow with raisins. Here, I'll show you something. I already have something lined up for that. I love when things work out. Oh, it is Clarice. Hello, Clarice. Council of Crows. So yeah, we already have someone like that. Anyway, back to this. Okay, I was looking at this. Bludgeoning, they have damage resistance to bludgeoning, piercing, and slashing. Charmed, frightened, paralyzed, petrified, prone, restrained, stunned. The storm can occupy another creature's space. And vice versa. Beaks. One target in the storm space, 2d6 piercing damage, or 1d6 piercing if a swarm has half its hit points. I want to create my own. I want to create the Vedranis Crows. I'm going to create a monster for this. This is a sidebar, but it's so needed. Swarm of Ravens. Monster name. Vedranis, Crows of Vedranis. Version Juan. I want to make them a little bit meaner. A little bit beefier, maybe. What I'm thinking is, I want them to have like a certain action when something happens that they do. So like they do less damage when there's when they have half their hit points, but I want them to almost go into a frenzy and maybe give them something there. That's fine. Do 10d8, I guess. Average hit points. So if it's 10d8 minus 7. Oops. Okay, let's do this really quick. Calculator. I love it, chat. This is why we do this shit. So 37 hit points would be their average. That's pretty nasty, man. You don't want to... Something like Cloud of Daggers spell. Ooh, I'd have to look that up. I can't remember that off the top of my head, but I like the sound of it already. Buff Crows. If the players ask, you should make... you made this happen. So when they swarm the area within them, equivalent of darkness. Oh my god. You guys are mean. I wasn't thinking. You're like, oh, it's darkness and a fucking spell. You guys are... That is nasty. I like it. Okay. Cloud of Daggers. You fill the air with spinning daggers in a 5-foot cube on each side, centered on a point you choose within range. A creature takes 44 slashing damage when it enters the spell's area for the first time or starts its turn there. Ooh. That could be interesting. I don't think these crows are gonna... I don't think the players are gonna like these crows once they,
once this encounter happens.
I'm a hell of a DM when it comes to consequences. When I break out the evil laugh, they get worried, lol. Because right now it'll kill everyone, I think. I don't think it will, I don't think it'll be that bad, because what is their normal damage is 2d6. Essentially, it's just going to be a one-time damage. Or a recharge? I don't know. We could do a recharge ability. Their int would be higher, wouldn't it? Like an 8 intelligence, maybe? Fuck if I know. Let's see. See, I don't know how to do all that, but... Actually, the Swarm of Ravens isn't bad. Maybe bludgeoning a buffing attack from the wings as well as the biggest attack. What I was thinking is a one-time... So once the Ravens get to half HP, they do a one-time, essentially, cloud of daggers. So within like a 5-foot square or whatever, a player takes 44 slashing damage. So if someone's in there swatting at him, they take him down to half HP, that's when they go like fucking crazy for a little bit. Yeah, exactly. So I can do that. Cloud of beaks. I don't know how this I should word this. Once the crows reach half. I'm gonna call it Cloud of Bloodied Beaks. That's what we're gonna call it. Half HP, they instantly do 4d4 piercing damage to any target within range. Talons, Murder Cloud, no, just murder. Episode title, A Murder This Way Comes, lol. I love it. That's hilarious. Hey, Boba. Come lay down, Bobby. Okay. So yeah, essentially, once the crows reach half HP, they instantly do 44 piercing damage. I think I have another. I don't have it on here. I don't know what the CR would be of these things. I'm gonna just do one half. So with our Kobold Fight Club, buddy, what are you doing? Gracious, my cat. Ow. Where's a one half real quick? I just want to see what it changes the encounter. It does make the difficult hard. It does make it difficult. Yo, they won't even know you're talking about the crows until it happens. That's true. True. Okay, let me just save the changes really quick, and we need to find a picture. I don't know what the song is, but it's creepy. Oh, the Skaven come out to play. I want to re... This is perfect music for the Crows of Verdranus. Love it. Oh my god, this is terrifyingly perfect. I don't think the players will ever see that. Check Discord. Oh, we can give them a preview, ACN. I'm down for that. I have it right here in my thing, so... There we go. There is our crows of Adranus, medium swarm of tiny beasts. So, we need to go back to our map. Now let's put that up here. We'll title it Kyrogen Encounter. Oh, I don't want to put my players over there. I just want to be over there. Yeah, is that a good enough picture? I think that's pretty good. And just imagine the players fight these crows or whatever, and they're like, fuck crows. Fuck yo beak mask. Fuck yo beak. Right? And then all of a sudden, they get back to Hallow. And there's a crow sitting on the perch of the Sentinel's Rest. I love it. Okay. We need a swarm of ravens. Raven. I want to put crows into the overlay just for the episode with a crow encounter. You can if you want. Hello, Peter. How are you? Just came by to say hi. Hello. A raven man? I want to put them in hidden and then turn them on when they appear. That would be fucking amazing. That would be amazing. I think you have to do it. This episode is all about consequences. I'm in a weird mood, but good. Hope you're all good, you amazing people. I hope you're doing amazing. 19... Oh, that's a bundle. You're more than welcome to hang out with us. Ooh, dire wolves are in this one. Giant bats? Django, you can't have cake. Giant lizard? Giant snakes? Grimlocks are in this? Nightwalkers? Oh my god. I might buy this one. A panther? A displacer beast? Oh my, all the swarms. Oh my, there's so much. We're buying this one. 100%. I'm also in Kate's Dream Rhythm. Do crows have dark vision? My crows have dark vision. That's not big enough. Oops. Oh god. Conflicting feelings about two people at the moment. It's a small swarm. It's a medium swarm, god damn it. Ah! I almost want them just like this. That's a lot of crows. Okay, if we're at 100%. I don't think the players will be able to tell. Like, I almost want to make it like this. a huge swarm, a gargantuan swarm. It's the eagles. We just turned into Lord of the Rings. It's fine. Yeah, if they did that, I could be like, blam, you know, like, blam, blam, all over. I might keep them that size, even though they're technically not large. I just want the players to be able to see the, I want the players to see the tokens. I mean, if I'm paying $5 for that, they're seeing that shit. I say make them large as it's nicely intimidating and a good visual. Exactly. Okay, so we've got them at 37.
Is that a little much? Is that a little much? They have more HP than the fucking doctor. Who's a CR2? And they're resistant. Look, they're resistant to bludgeoning, piercing, and slashing. They're taking half damage from my players. I'm so mean. Is this
too much? They might be too strong. They might be too strong. Nah, what level characters are they? They're level 3. The thing about them being level 3, though, is they can't take a long rest. You know, they can't take a long rest till they get back to Hallow. So that's a ways away. That's like three days away from where they're at. So I can't just... Like, they can't just take a long rest. And they have to fight the fucking... They have to fight the thing. The wretched crawler still. But that might give them more of an incentive to run into Aedrid's place. Yeah, I think that's okay. We can adjust it on the fly, you're right. I just spammed you things I can add to the overlay. I like that second picture a lot. I don't know if there's a way we can add some ravens into the branches, but I love that second one, ACN. I believe you mean swole crows? Yeah. So they can make it move 50 feet, which it would have to be... They can move... Oh my god. So they can fucking pelt the players. Like, they can get there pretty fast. It's freaking happening. Hell yeah. So we've got that. We need to add that to my... Let's see. Rose of Adranus will appear... How many rounds should we say after the first Kyrogen falls? The thing is, you want the crows to be a deterrent, right? A reason not for them to mess with the folks of the city, let alone other crows, a tough fight. Yeah, no, that's true. And it is a direct consequence, right? It's not like I'm adding it to make the encounter harder. I'm literally doing it. I'm literally doing it for the consequence that they've chosen, you know? And then the doctors could get away. Ooh, my god, you guys are so smart. The crows of Adranus will appear. I'm just gonna say two rounds after the first Kyrogen falls, DC 13 perception to hear them. How creepy would that be, chat?
I did a brain. I feel like Grog.
How scary would that be? They're in the midst of this fight, right? They're fighting these doctors, and they're like, oh,
it went down super easy.
Or, like, one of them dies super easy. They've got 9 fucking hit points. And then all of a sudden, no, I want everyone to see this. And then all of a sudden, they hear the flapping of wings and the cawing of something quickly approaching their way. Ooh, chat. We need to pause the music because we need to find appropriate music. I wonder how this would work. So we have our combat music to kind of switch up. We have combat music. Right? There we go. What if all of a sudden we... You're making these crows? Yeah, but not just one caw, many caws. For Gavin and ACN, just so you know, I'm going to say this, that the crows have green eyes. Like emerald green eyes. And what if we turned like this music on? There's a break in the fight. As you all stop for a moment. As you begin to hear the flapping of wings and the many caws of something quickly approaching. And all of a sudden, the Kyrogen seem reinvigorated, excited, happy about the sound that they hear. And then this fuck. I need to download this sound. I need an MP3 of this sound so I can play it in the campaign when this happens. There you go. Oh, I'm so fucking excited. I'm so excited, chat. I hope you are. Yeah, so. That's creepy as fuck. Oh my god. Oh my god. I am so excited. There's a YouTube to MP3 converter. I could, yeah, that's probably what I'll end up doing, actually. Is something like that. Oh. Also, I know ACN wanted me to show you guys this. So I'm going to show you the work in progress of the map. So here we go. This is Vedranis. Let me hide my webcam for a second. Or can I scroll down? Wrong border. This is Vedranis, as the map is. Hide the statue.
Hide the statue. Where is it? Blech.
I'm so bummed I'm gonna miss it live because I have D&D at the same time. Oh shit, Lita, that sucks. But we'll have the VOD for you. I'm so hyped. So yeah, so down here, this is Hallow right here. Hallow is in this area. The players are they're up in here. This isn't an exact representation of every single building and whatnot. It's more just to show the sheer size. So they've made it here in 4 days. So 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Could take almost a month to travel from Hallow to the edge of the map. That does not count getting over to all of this area too. So there's your little snippet of the map that we're working with, that the players will be traversing. What the heck, that's huge. Yeah, Padronus is the size of a country. It is the size of a small country. It is a gigantic city. The water looks so good. And I like seeing all the other buildings on the outskirts and like some that have been like absorbed and whatnot by the water. I think that's freaking awesome. So yeah, okay. Which was actually the easiest part, in a way. Gonna VOD and be here as soon as I can. Hell yeah. So yeah, I think we might be good. I don't think we have much more to plan. Let me look at my notes again. So, done. The lore around the ravens and crows is done. It'll be a work in progress as we continue to kind of figure out what the heck's going on, but I mean, that was all on my to-do list. I'm really excited now. I'll have to think of the why, obviously. Why do the crows protect people of Adranas? And we'll figure that out later. That's something we can work on at another point. Yeah, I think that's where we're gonna end it for tonight. Thank you guys for hanging out. I appreciate you guys being here. If you guys aren't a part of the Infinite RP Discord, go ahead and follow. I think we have a YouTube command too. Is it YouTube like that? Or YouTube? Maybe not. Make sure to follow the YouTube as well. The link should be down below in the About section. That's where all the VODs will be. So if you can't make it on Thursday to see this encounter that we have prepped, which is going to be immediately the first encounter that the players, like the first thing that the players do is jumping into this encounter. So if you can't make it live, make sure you check out and subscribe to the YouTube. The VODs go up on Saturdays. And then you can watch the VOD as well right after. Thank you, ACN. You can watch the VOD right after the show's over on Twitch. And then the VOD for the YouTube channel will go up. If you are not following Infinite RP on Twitter and Twitch, what are you doing? Follow us. As well as if you guys haven't watched the two episodes, make sure to watch them. Who has not watched the episodes yet? Has anybody not watched the first two episodes? Tyler hasn't. Tyler, god damn it. Just kidding. Yeah, we also post the notifications on Twitter and Discord. I'm about to right now. I'm really excited about this campaign. The first two episodes are a little on the slower side, but there's a lot of lore, a lot of cool stuff that's happening. And they're only like 3 hours long, so they're pretty quick. So, but yes, thank you guys so much for hanging out tonight. I really appreciate it. I'll be doing behind the screen. I'll be doing this every Monday. So make sure if you enjoyed this, make sure to tune in every Monday at 9 p.m. Eastern. I'll be doing this every week for the foreseeable future. Until they tell me I have to change days. So, but yeah. I haven't watched all of them, but I was here for most of it. That's fair. I know you were good for like episode two. You were there for a good chunk of it. Yeah. So, next episode is gonna be. I need to think of a title. I like some of the suggestions that we had already. But we'll think of a title for sure. But yeah, that's gonna do it. That's gonna do it for me tonight, everybody. Thank you guys so much for hanging out. I appreciate and love each and every one of you. And we will see you guys on Thursday for episode 3 of The Lost City of Vadranas. Have a wonderful night, guys. We will see you later.